Hey, what's up? My name is Ines Alea, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a sci-fi eye effect in Adobe After Effects. Let's get started. For this video, I'm going to be using the Acer Concept D7 Pro Easel. Why easel, you ask? Let me demonstrate. Honestly, this is one of my favorite features for this laptop. One, it's an industry standard laptop with some really amazing specs for running VFX on your laptop on the go. It's really capable because it comes with a Xeon processor and a Quadro RTX 5000 graphics card from Nvidia, which is insane to be inside of a laptop. And it also looks really dope, and yeah, it's different, and I like different. So if you want to follow along with the exact same footage as me, I will put a link in the description where you can download that. I will work with this clip right here. So I'm looking straight into the camera. I'm going to drag and drop this footage into a new composition. The first thing that I want to do is add the Mocha AE effect to my clip. So I'm going to my effects and presets, search Mocha AE, add that to your clip, and click on the logo for Mocha. But before you do that, make sure that you're working here in full resolution, and now we can click and open up Mocha. All right, so right here, I'm going to choose my X-Plane tool and then hold Z on the keyboard and zoom in on my eye. With the X, you can pan around, so hold X and drag around. And I want to select the inner eye, so everything that is within my eye. And then right-click once you're done, hold Ctrl and press A to select all of these dots, and then just pull them in a little bit to make them softer. And now we can click here and track forward. So once in a while, you can pause your track and just adjust your track to be perfect. To do that, I'm going to zoom in as big as possible here, and we're going to just drag this in here and make it as perfect as you can. Obviously, the more time you're going to spend here, the better your result will be. So do this as perfect as you can. This is going to be my left eye, so I'm going to double click on this layer and then rename it to left eye. And if you want to repeat the process for the other eye, you can just redo the entire process, select your X-Plane tool, and then move over to the other eye and start over from the first frame or wherever you want and work from there. But I'm just going to concentrate on one eye for this tutorial. So now we're going to close Mocha and save all the changes. And now we're going to right click and create a new null object. This is going to be my tracking data, so I'm going to hit return and rename this tracking data, and then go to my footage and go into the tracking data, create track data, and then select that layer, click OK. And then right here, we're going to click transform and select the tracking data null and apply the export. If you have the other track eye, you would have to select the other layer here, click OK, and then redo this process for another null. So we now have this null following my eye. So now I want to concentrate on the eye design. So I'm going to create a new composition, and I'm going to make this 1000 by 1000 so everyone can work with me here. Eye design, and hit return. And in here, I'm going to enable my title action save. Then I'm going to choose my ellipse tool and zoom in. Start from the center, hold Ctrl and Shift and drag out until we have something like this. And then I'm going to click here on fill. I'm going to give it no fill, click OK. And then for the stroke, I'm going to give it a wide stroke, and I'm going to increase this stroke line. By the way, if you want to make these designs in Illustrator or Photoshop, you can do that as well. That's no problem. You can design them either in After Effects or take more time in Illustrator. I'm just going to show you a few techniques on how to design your own elements in Adobe After Effects. So now that we have this, we can duplicate this shape layer. We can scale it down a little bit just like this. And one thing that I'm going to do here is go over to layer and pre-compose this. So I make this like a pixel-based circle. And I'm just going to call this circle comp. And in here, I'm going to choose my pen tool. And I'm going to start from the center, work my way outside like this, and then come back a little bit like that, and then work my way back to the center. And now I have this kind of piece that is coming or sticking out. So you can do this, if you want to make this smaller, you can just drag this in or out. So like this, you would be able to control little pieces on the side. You can also double click on this mask and then hold control and duplicate it. And then you can rotate it to the other side, for example, like this. Or you could just duplicate this footage and delete the masks and just start over here for a small one. And like this, you get these different elements. I'm also going to create another ellipse. So what you can do is just duplicate this shape layer, Control D. And in here, I'm going to open up all the details. So I'm going to open up the contents for the ellipse. And right here, we will also see transform settings where we also have the scale. So I'm going to scale it down a little bit like this. And then I'm going to work my way down here for the stroke. Go and open up the stroke and choose right here to have dashes. So add the dashes, click here on the plus. And now we get this design right here, which looks really cool and detailed. So you can play here with the dashes and the offset to change the look of this however you'd like. I'm again going to duplicate this same layer, and this time I'm going to lower the pixels for the stroke. And I'm going to open up it again and go into the contents, ellipse, and this time, well, also for the scale here. Just going to scale it down a little bit so we get some extra detail. And all you want to do is detail this thing out, so with the techniques that I've shown you. And there we go. This looks pretty cool. And in here, you can also add like an effect on top of your shape layers. So what you can do is go over to Effect, go into Blur and Sharpen, and add a fast box blur here. And if we're going to increase that, we're just going to blur these elements a little bit, and these are going to make it look a little bit more realistic. So I'm going to copy this fast box blur. Another technique that you could use, for example, would be, I'm just going to apply that to another one. Let's say this layer right here. I'm going to apply the effect blur and sharpen. And here I'm going to add the channel blur and increase that. And that's just going to soften the edges a little bit, and that's going to give it a little bit of a hotspot feeling. Like if you look into a light or a softbox that is standing here right in front of me, you will see that the center point is very white, but the edges are darker because the light gets, it has a fall off. So if you want to create that fake fall off, you can do that using the alpha blurriness. And I would also combine this with a very subtle fast box blur. So I'm going to add the fast box blur on top of that, set the iterations to 1 and set the radius to 1. Now we have a soft blur on the edges. I'm going to copy these two blurs. And what you could do is actually cut them. So I'm going to edit and cut them away. And I'm just going to apply them on an adjustment layer. So they're applied to every single layer here. I'm just going to close everything down and then right click here, new adjustment layer, and paste with Control V the effects that we've just cut. And now we have this element right here. And maybe you don't want it on one particular element, you can bring that out of on top. So like this, you can also create depth by changing your blurry values. I'm going to also make the outer circle a little bit thinner because I think it's a little bit too dark. A little bit too thick. So this looks really, really cool. Now we have a few techniques on how we want to add some animation to these elements. We already have the look down, but we don't have any animation. We want them to rotate around a little bit or rotate continuously. So to do these things, we're going to be using some basic expressions in Adobe After Effects, which are really, really easy and simple to grasp. So if it's your first time with expressions, these are like the perfect expressions to get into expressions. So we're going to press R on the keyboard to bring up the rotation here, and I'm going to hold Alt and click on the stopwatch here and write a simple expression like wiggle, open parentheses, 0.5, comma, and then I'm going to set it to like 360. So what this does is over the time of 2 seconds, because the first value stands per second. So if you would add 1, that would mean every single second, but 0.5 means every 2 seconds, it's going to randomly change with a value of 360 in the rotation. So if you're going to play this, you're not going to see anything because I added it to the wrong effect. So what I can do to just make this visible is open up the contents, go into the stroke, and also add these dashes here. And now we're going to see that if we're going to play this, we get some random rotation here that is pretty slow because we do it every 2 seconds. If you want to speed it up, you just want to increase the first value in your wiggle preset. So I'm just going to press E twice on the keyboard. If you press that quickly, you're going to bring up all the effects that have expressions applied to them. I'm going to hold Control and press C on the keyboard to copy this wiggle expression, and then select all of my layers, press R on the keyboard, and now I can go over all of these. So Alt click and paste it. Maybe above that one, Alt click, and you can not paste it, but maybe you want to write something differently. So this time we're going to do something continuously. Now it's like rotating a little bit randomly with a wiggle preset, but if you want to have like a continuous rotation, you can use the time preset. So we're going to write time. Here we need to add the asterisk and then write the amount. So maybe 100. So every second it's going to add 100 to the rotation. So if we're going to look at this, it's now going to have a continuous rotation to the right, just like that. If you want to reverse the rotation, we can add a minus here to reverse the animation counterclockwise. And so like that, we can work with the time expression. And now I'm just going to add the wiggle to the other two, just so we can wrap this effect up. So now all of the gears are rotating and it looks really cool. It looks really advanced. And yeah, you can still work on this more and add even more detail if you'd like. But now once you're satisfied with your design, you can go back to your main composition and just add that circle comp to your composition. I'm going to scale it down here and place it onto my eye. And I actually brought in the wrong comp. If you ever do that, you can just click on this comp, select the right comp here and hold Alt and then drag it over and boom, it's going to replace that. And so now we are going to see that we have our effect on top of our eye. We can just now parent this to the null track data and we can also set our screen resolution to full, which it is. It's just zoomed in quite a lot. And now we want to add, for example, a tint effect to this to color it a little bit. So we're going to apply the tint effect to our eye design, change the white color here to a nice, maybe purple this time, or maybe we want like more of a red tone, click OK. If you want it to be brighter, you can go more towards the white. And always important to add perfect glow on top of all of your effects to make them look really, really cool. And then set the blending mode to screen, and press T on the keyboard to lower the opacity a little bit to just blend the effect a little bit better with the eye itself. And I'm just going to change the color to maybe more of a golden look, like that. And now that we have parented it to the track data, we should see that it's working fine. We just have one more thing to do, and that's to make sure that once my like my eyelid is coming over it, that it's masking that out. And because we've done the mocha track, we can now go into the matte and create AE mats or masks and press M on the keyboard and then just cut away this left eye mask. So Control X, right click, new, solid eye mask, click OK. And then paste the mask. But before you do that, make sure you go all the way to the beginning and paste it here. And then bring this on top of your eye design and set your eye design track matte to alpha matte. If you don't see that, you can toggle the switches right here or press F4. Then I'm going to press F on the keyboard so I can feather this mask a little bit and set it to something like 4. So now we have a soft feather and we should have our final look. So in the mask, you can see some small mistakes here because I really rushed through the masking process. But apart from that, the eye looks super dope, and that's basically it on how to create sci-fi eyes. You can always create another adjustment layer to add some reflections here or something like that. And you can also add, for example, these metal cyborg effects on top of the eyes here. And if you want a better glow, what you can always do is add the solid composite effect right here before your glow. That's going to make it pop a lot more, and you can always increase the intensity a little bit. But as you can see, this really makes it pop, and on this monitor it looks fantastic in 4K, and it's also Pantone certified, which means that you're working with industry standard colors. So now all there is to do is add some color grading, and that gives you something like this. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, I'm going to leave you with another upload of mine so you can continue enjoying my videos. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.